Good evening. Hey, welcome back to the Caribbean Voice presentation of A Mind-Body Connection. It's all about depression and self-care. We got kicked off from our other live video and we are back. That's right. We don't get kicked off that easily and stay down. We always rise above.
All right. Yes, yes. Hello to Marlon Dan from Trinidad and Tobago. Pardesi Babu. Thanks for tuning in. Sherry Mohammed. And your friend again is on, John.
Hey, the famous John from Queens. That's our celebrity here.
So, we can say some of the things that could cause depression.
Well, some of the things that could cause depression is a loss of a spouse, loss of a child, loss of your job, and if you're diagnosed with any kind of major sickness.
Yes, like cancer, right. Breast cancer. You lose a limb, you know, all these things can cause
depression.
So you have to pay attention to, you know, keep, it's good to have.
As we say, your health is your wealth. So take care of your mind, body, and body meaning outer and inner, and your mind is a great thing you have to take care of.
Exactly. So, and you know what, since I know that we're going to be talking about depression today, you know, I'm no doctor, but I want to go and do a role play to see what you guys need to do. And anybody could go and see if they're depressed. When you go to your doctor, they're supposed to, like, it's like a mandate for you to check to see if you're depressed. And so there's a form that you call a patient health questionnaire, which is PHQ. So I'm going to read these questions, and I'm going to ask Shanaz to...
I have to fill out answers.
Let she fill out the answers to me, and we'll see if she is depressed or not.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Yes, we give this survey at work, actually, for all of our patients and our staff.
Really?
Because we really, every quarterly, we do a quality assessment of patient care. And we give them the survey, and what is important is about some folks can't tell the difference between being sadness and depression. Now, sadness is very temporary. You can get sad from moment to moment.
Yes.
They don't realize depression is a long term, right?
Well, depression could be long term, and it could be temporary. It could last a year, 6 months. But with good care and good treatment, you can beat depression. It's not a life sentence.
All right.
So let me go ahead and ask Shanaz the questions.
Guys, feel free to fill out your answers in your mind. We're going from not at all, several days, more than half a day, or nearly every day. So everything that Mr. Hiram will be asking us, we have not at all, several days, more than half a day, and nearly every day. So you could circle one of the two. Or
right.
One of
and
the four.
We're hoping that Shanaz is not depressed anyway. We're just playing. I'm just playing with her.
If I am, at least I know I'll be getting help, because the Caribbean Voice is here to help. And we are a non-judgmental group. And we're here, very confidential group of an organization, I should say. Very confidential. So if you need help or you know someone that needs help, and hey, it doesn't make us less to say we need help in something, right?
Of course.
We need to acknowledge where we need help. That's the only way we could get help.
Yes.
So
yes.
I love this. I love the game. So
don't be shy or embarrassed to say that you're depressed. So question number one, Shanaz, do you have a little interest or pleasure in doing anything?
Nope, not at all. As you can see, I'm up and about, rain or shine, I'm out there doing my thing. I'm an outdoor person.
Okay, good.
So if you don't see me driving around or doing shopping, then you could say, okay, something's bothering Shanaz.
Right. So let's see, are you feeling down, depressed, or are you hopeless?
Nope, that's a zero for me.
Number three, trouble falling or staying asleep or sleeping too much?
Well, I hate going to bed, but when I'm in bed, my bed is my best friend, but I could be up until 2, but I'm always doing something. But when I'm in bed, I'm sleeping until 11, so no.
Do you feel tired or having a little or no energy?
Well, that's a normal thing, because you go to sleep at 2 a.m. Sometimes you feel a little bit, you know, less energetic, but no, I'm good to go.
Good. Number 5. What about your appetite? Poor appetite, or are you overeating, Shanaz?
Well, yesterday I had two sapodilla, and as we were talking earlier, I know you went and get some of those
star apples.
So we have the same thing. Give me all the fruits, and I will definitely overeat on fruits. But when it comes to regular meals, you know, eat well, sleep well, and, you know, talk to somebody, and you'll have an overall control of your mind and body. So, yeah, I eat maybe 3 meals a day, not overeating.
Good, good. You are doing very good. Are you feeling bad about yourself, or that you are a failure, or having let yourself or your family down?
Nope. I'm very motivated, and I love motivating others to do their best.
Very good. Number 7, trouble concentrating on things such as reading the newspaper or watching television. Well, you're on TV all the time, so I...
Well, I don't have time to watch the television. I'm always behind the television. But yes, it could be distracting. This little gadget we all love so much, I wanted to toss it against the wall today because it keeps going tick, 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 tick. And that was all the notification. But then I said, you know what? That's anger. So I did not get angry. I said the phone, I turned off the notification, and I was good with my phone again. We made peace.
Yes.
So guys, you know, as much as we all love our gadgets, it could be overbearing. If you know someone at work, and all day I get message, all day, all hour of the night. And I do sleep. My phone says active all the time, but I'm not on Facebook as much as the phone giveaway. You know, the phone tells everybody I'm on, but I'm not on Facebook. I'm actually sleeping sometimes.
Okay, good for you. Number 8, moving or speaking so slowly that other people could have noticed, or the opposite, being so feisty or restless that you have been moving around a lot more than usual.
Now, Mr. Hiram have to answer that one for me. So, I think I'm always a little fast when it comes to speaking and doing things. And a walker, I'm a fast walker.
Oh, good, that's not a problem. It's good to walk, yeah.
It's good to walk, right.
So, thoughts that you would be better off dead or hurting yourself?
Definitely not. We are gifted with a gift that's called life, and we have one life to live. Live it to the fullest. Every day is a new day, and if you don't like the chapter of yesterday, remember, if you wake up tomorrow, it's a chance to make it better.
Yes, you can always press the reset button.
And start all over again. Choose your friends wisely, and do not associate yourself with people who brings you down.
So we will talk about that. Remind me to talk about that when we finish this here.
Right.
Number 10, if you check off any problems, how difficult have these problems made it for you to do your work, take care of things at home, or get along with other people?
Not difficult at all.
So now that's very good. It shows that Shanaz is not depressed. And I'll tell you how I know.
At the moment.
Yes.
I'm not depressed at the moment.
Right. And this has to be like consistently, like for 2 weeks, Shanaz. This is just a one-day business.
Right.
So if you feel down today, that's fine. If you feel down tomorrow, that's fine. But if you consistently feel
down,
like all these things that I'm reading here, then you are clinically depressed. And I'll recommend that you go see a doctor. So now we have a scoring sheet. And it says 1 to 4, you are minimal depressed. Right? 5 to 9, you're mildly depressed. 10 to 14, you're moderately depressed. 15 to 19, you're moderately depressed. Severe depression. 20 to 27, you're severely depression. Now you know, Shanaz, this is a good thing. Now, if you're depressed, it's good to know. And your doctor, your medical doctor could do either things. Mm-hmm. He could either prescribe you medication. I got to have
a doctor. They normally say happy pills.
Yeah. They could give you some medication for depression, or they can send you to see a psychiatrist, which is the ideal thing to do, so they could treat you. And the thing is that now they have, let's say, things like Prozac or Zoloft. Your doctor will give you those medication, and what you will have to do is to give yourself at least like 2 months before this medication could really work and get into your system, and you will see some improvement. If you don't see improvement 1 week or two, don't get worried. Don't get excited. You know, after 2 months and so on, then you can go and speak to your doctor. And you can ask, let him know, be honest with your doctor. Always tell him the truth. Let him know how you're feeling.
Holding back information is not going to help you.
You know, so what your doctor could do, he could give you another medication to help you with one of the medications that you're already taking, to help to complement each other. So that's a good thing, right?
It is.
Always talk to your doctor how you're going to feel.
Be honest and open. That's the only way you could get the care you need.
And don't stop taking your medication. It is not recommended. Take your medication consistently on a daily basis. And if one day you forget to take your medication, when you remember to take your medication, you can go ahead and do it, especially if it's a once-a-day medication. But if it's 2 times a day and you remember 2 o'clock and the other medication is due at 6 o'clock, then I would recommend you don't take it, okay?
Also, meditation helps depression.
Well, we can talk about that too.
Go ahead. Tell us how meditation helps someone when they're depressed.
So, you know, there's a couple... Then we're going to talk about self-care a little bit there.
And that's part of self-care because we all need to free our minds sometimes. You know, that's detoxing from our day. Sometimes we all need a cup of coffee just to sit down and have a 5 minutes to ourselves. I feel it's detoxing our mind at the end of the day.
Yes. You know what? I've been lucky and blessed. You know, Shanaz, when I wake up in the morning, I feel like, no, don't laugh. I feel like I'm the blackest crow there is. I don't think nobody's better than me or I'm not better than anybody else. I feel good about myself and I feel good.
We're all individual. Our fingers are not the same length or color.
Right.
We're all created differently, but we're all with the same heart.
Yes, yes. And so one of the things I want to say tonight is that we must love ourselves. If we don't love ourselves, then who's going to love? We can't expect anybody else to love us. So always good to love yourself. Another thing that I really do and pay effort in is to set the tone in my home for love and for everything else. You know, when I come home, Geeta is happy to see me. The boys are happy to see me. Well, thank God for that. Geeta and the boys, thank you very much. I love that. You know, you set the tone for a good family. You know
right.
what I'm saying? Always. The other thing is, do not let people define who you are. Don't let nobody tell you how fat you are, how black you are. When you wake up and you look at your own self, know that you are
beautiful,
a good,
inside out. And
yes.
If you have a good heart, that's all that matters. Because you know what? Sometimes not all that glitters is gold, right? As they said it outside, sometimes you can look very pretty, but if you have a nasty attitude, it's not going to take you anywhere.
Exactly.
Well, Auntie Una said she passed her test too, as she was taking it along with me.
Oh, that's
Nalini,
nice.
Nalini, good night to you. Stanley Saran, good night to you. Sonia Devadin says she loved. Hey, she's saying I'm overeating. I think so. I'll admit to overeating. Hey, Trevor, good night to you. Good night to each and every one of you. Locked on to FireFest 101. We'll be right back. ख्वाबों में ख्यालों में फंसा के रखूं मैं तो तुझे पलकों में छुपा के रखूं आजा महबूबा तू मेरा एतबार कर इश्क है तो इश्क का इजहार कर इश्क है तो इश्क का इजहार कर Well, yes, we at the Caribbean Voice love you, love each and every one of you like crazy.
I'm not the one who's running out of time.
Hey, good night to Mr. Kabir Das. Real Salvage. Good evening. Good evening, Neela. How are you doing this evening? Thank you, guys. All is golden. We do love the Olies as much as you love the Olies. Auntie Una said she loved relaxing to her bhajans, and that's her time. Everybody need to find some time for themselves, what makes you happy, and spend some time.
Yes.
So what do you do on your recreation time, other than judging the birds and feeding the birds?
Well, you know what, you know, Shanaz, we have to do, when you're depressed, I'll answer your question.
No, before we get depressed, what should we do on a normal basis to keep our mind flowing so we wouldn't be depressed?
You know, it's always good to do things that you love to do. Always find, like, if you like to go walk your dog, you like to do a little gardening, go ahead and do that. Feel free. Another good thing to do is you have your friend who you can trust, but you have to be very careful of people these days. So
be very selective
of your friends. Get friends who are going to uplift you, who will compliment you, not who's going to backtack you or put you down because you're fat and all these kind of things. Get good friends who would compliment you despite whatever it is.
And motivate you sometimes, no matter what you're going through. They all say, let's do it together. So if I know someone, we could go to the gym. Okay, let's go to the gym if I know you need that. If I know you need a little prayer, I'll make it my habit to say, let's pray here. Let's do this.
Oh, that's a good thing. That's a good thing. Yes. We must help each other out, Shanaz. Mm-hmm. You know, life is not easy. It's very difficult, especially here in the United States.
Right. It's work. And sometimes you don't get to see your families. You don't get to see your kids, and they don't realize the sacrifice you're making out there working.
In fact, to be very honest with you, I've been doing 2 full-time jobs now for many years, and
I've been praying so he could join me on Monday. Recently, I've been praying so he could be off on Mondays and join me in the studio, and I guess...
She got me cracking up.
And look, you see how hard I'm praying? I have the Holy Bible in front of me, so now he could definitely be here in the Firefest studio every Monday, 8 to 10 p.m.
Yes, I was surprised. You know, last month, I did 2 full-time jobs for 8 years. And, you know, surprisingly, my boss, they called me last week and said they're going to cut my hours. Because, you know, to come in the studio every week at Mondays, I am working. So, surprisingly, they called me and said, you know what, we're cutting your hours. So now, Shanaz will have me every Monday, whenever she wants.
You guys will have him here in the studio every Monday. And his number, he'll put it in the chat box. So if you guys need help, please do call him. He's very helpful. I know a few friends who reached out to him over the weekend.
Yes.
And they have said, you know, they told me you'd give them very good advice.
Yes. One thing I said to myself, and I thanks to Anand that he is giving me this opportunity. You know, I am totally committed to help the Caribbean Voice in helping people from not committing suicide, to see there is something else better than...
Other options out there.
There is so much options. And, you know, I will take your call anytime when I'm at work. If you give me a number, I will definitely call you back. You know, if you're looking for a psychiatrist, I can always help navigate you to a good psychiatrist, or tell you where to go. I shared it at my office with a psychiatrist. So if there's something that's bothering you and you can get to a doctor and you want to know the answer, you can just inbox me your question and I'll definitely talk to Dr. Tan, and he is going to answer your question. He's a very good guy, good friend of mine. Like I said, we share the same office and we meet every Friday. We spend 8 hours at least in the same office. So don't be scared. You can always contact me on Facebook, which I see people been doing, and I say thank you very much, and I hope that we will continue to be a source, you know, to this organization and for you guys.
Reach out to someone or direct someone that you know might need the help. Don't be afraid. Just give them Mr. Hiron's number and they could call him at their convenience. Good evening to Dr. Harold, one of our psychologists. He'll be joining us in the studio in an upcoming week. So guys, write all your questions, your comments, your concern, and our psychologist, Dr. Harold, will be in the studio pretty soon. Good evening to the founder of the Caribbean Voice, Mr. Anand Budram, and all the members in Guyana doing the work, you know, that we're not there.
Yeah.
Well, we do have loyal members and our volunteer. I must say, Caribbean Voice is a non-for-profit organization. We have volunteers dedicating their time and their effort into making everyone life a little bit better.
Yes, and I know Bibi is doing a fantastic job there in Guyana with the team. She's very involved. I am hoping to go back sometime next year to see what I could do. I want to make it an annual journey back home to Guyana to see the, to just add my little sense and my little penny to see how I can help. We want to say hello to, big up to Mr. Savage. Thank you for tuning in. Please do share our page and like our page. Neela Narine, loving the tunes. Yes, Shanaz always have her music down pat before we get into studio.
George Moneyram, good night to you. Auntie Una, thank you very much. Auntie Una is a very good supporter and friend of our community. Mr. Anand Budrang said, in effect, he said about, we're talking about meditation. It says, well, different things work for different folks, but meditation, what's your thought on it? It works?
Yes. You know, and the truth of the matter is, I heard that I was reading some things today, and which I want to do. I never get a chance to do, and I want to do it in my own life, is that they said, like, give yourself like 5 minutes in the morning to start meditating. Give yourself 5-10 minutes before the hustle and bustle starts. And you know what I like to do, Shanaz and my wife know, when I go to the store, I always like to go to the candle section.
And
I like to buy, I like jasmine and gardenia and so on. And I like to light it in my house and enjoy the nice fragrance, you know what I'm saying?
I love jasmine candles.
Yes, the good scent, right? So like in the morning time, you wake up, give yourself like a 5-10 minutes, meditate, put on some good relaxing music, and take yourself far away. Tell yourself how beautiful you are and how good you are. You're better than sliced cake, if you know what I mean.
You know, slice of cake. To, yeah. I read that title somewhere, Slice of Life. Hey, big up to Mr. Anand Budrang on his release of the brand new book. And I believe you could get it on Facebook. Hit him up and get your copy of A Slice of Life. Short stories, poems, and hopefully some secrets to Mr. Anand Budrang.
Yes, and you know what? One of the good things that he will be doing is that he will give back some of the money to the Caribbean Voice. And I thank you very much.
Raised by Mr. Anand's book will be going back to good use and going back to the Caribbean Voice nonprofit work that we are doing. New York, we're looking to launch in Trinidad, where right now we're focusing on Guyana. As they say, charity begins at home, and if you can't help the ones in your homeland, who else can you help?
Exactly so.
And depression is a universal language that all the countries are experiencing, not just Guyana.
Yes, and a lot of things like, let's talk about Guyana a little bit. You know, Guyana is a poor country, and so a lot of people lost their job. A lot of sugar workers, they've lost their jobs in Guyana. So, you know, with those people, you have to watch them. Because, you know, as a man, if you can't care for your family,
provide for your family,
you're
going to
be depressed, you know. And so we need the help and the support in Guyana. And, if you want to help us, the Caribbean Voice, you know, always you can go to our page. If you want to donate to us, please make a contribution to us so that we can continue our work in Guyana and elsewhere.
That's right, Mr. Anand Budrang. Yeah. We'll put the GoFundMe link in the chat box, and everyone please click on it. We will be launching in US next year. That's a good thing.
Yes.
We have counselors that's ready to take your call and your loved one's call, so keep them coming. Reach out to us, the Caribbean Voice, on Facebook, and follow us. You never know what's happening. We do share a lot on the Caribbean Voice Facebook page.
Exactly so. And one thing I want to add for treatment, you know, one of the things is that the cognitive behavioral therapy, when you're depressed, what also they could use is that you can get your psychologist, a therapist to talk to. So the negative thinking in your brain, redirect you to think positive things. You know, so with medication and therapy, it could do wonders, and you can get well.
Can depression be cured?
Well, the thing is that it could. Let me put it like
or
this:
just
it
control.
Could go into remission. It could go into remission for 5, 10, 15, 20 years. But one of the good things that you should know, if you have depression, try to live a healthy life. You know, watch what you eat, watch who you invite in your life. You don't want to have people in your life who's going to bring the worst in you every day. Bring somebody in your life who is going to compliment you to live a good life. You know what I'm saying? That when you come home, oh, I'm glad mommy is home. I'm glad my wife is home. I'm glad everybody, daddy is home. You know what I'm saying? So choose wisely.
आस मेरी एहसास मेरा ओ मेरी दिलरुबा तुम्हें दे दिया चुपके चुपके
दिल हमने दे लिया चुपके चुपके
ओ दिल रुबा
ओ साजना
ओ हमें तुमसे प्यार हो गया चुपके चुपके सौ सौ बार हो गया चुपके चुपके
दिल तुम्हें दे लिया चुपके चुपके
दिल हमने ले लिया चुपके चुपके ओ दिल रुबा
Good evening. Happy Monday. I know Monday is already finished. We all were excited to get back to work today. No, not really. Monday is such a boring day for us, right? Hey, Mr. Kabir Das, G2, good evening to you. Yes, we have a dinner and dance December 23rd, 6 p.m. to 1 a.m. at the Liberty Palace, 13007 Liberty Avenue. He said, see you. And my good friend, Mr. Buddy Singh, will be there. Anand Budram, the founder of the Caribbean Voice, is locked on. Thank you, thank you. And yes, he put the link for the GoFundMe in our chat. Big up to the management and staff of Firefest 101. And to you, Anand, thank you very much. Hey, my good friend, Nasima Rohaman, is all locked on from Toronto, Canada. Good night to you. Sharing is caring. Hit share so everyone or someone will benefit from our little talk. So Mr. Hiram has a lot of information he wants to read to you guys.
Yes. Let's say 8 tips for living with depression, Shanaz.
8 tips
I have here. So one of the tips is to build a support system. Mm-hmm. And let's say like you have your husband or your wife or your aunt. Mm-hmm. You have your family. Keep in touch with them. You know, it's a good thing to have your support around you. It's always good to have people around you. When you have people around you, you can conquer anything.
Yes.
You can do anything.
The right folks.
Folks,
you have, when
yes.
you have the right people around
yes.
you.
And
believe me, you can have some folks that will drain the life out of you.
Who are you telling? And you know what? Sometimes it's the bad thing is that it could be family.
All right.
Yeah, it could
you
be
call
some
them
of the family.
Toxic people. Let
yeah,
go
the
of toxic people that's bringing you down. Move
yes.
on. Turn the page. Get a new chapter. And surround yourself with people who make you feel good. Who empowers you?
Yes, and that could be a good friend. It doesn't necessarily have to be family. and reduce your stress. Like we said, Shanaz, if you have anything in your life that's causing any stress,
reassess.
It's time to go. Let go of your baggage.
And you know what? Changes are good. Sometimes we are afraid of changes, you know.
Yes.
We're accustomed to do the same routine over and over. But if it's making you unhappy, let go. Change is a good thing, you know. Every day is a new day for change. And Auntie Una says she dressed up. She feels good about herself. She goes shopping and get a job that you love.
Exactly. So if you have a job that you, I mean, I can't do a job that I don't love. I don't know. It's going to be tough. If you have a job that you love, that's the best thing you could ever do. It's like if you work hard, it's like you never work a day in your life.
Because whoever you're working for, they appreciate your labor, you know, and it's not a job anymore. You're going there, you enlighten someone day, you know, with a smile. You can make someone day better.
Yes, and always work with a smile.
Yes.
It's really, you never know how your patients, if you're taking your patients or whoever you're taking care of, that smile. I always look into people when I go out to see who are smiling and how their face look. I really look at their appearance. It goes a far way and tell a whole lot of story about you there as an individual.
And
you
if they can't smile or they look sad, give them your smile. That's what Imran always said. Give them your smile. Lend them your smile.
And talk about Imran. I want to say thank you to Imran for coming in and when I was not here to
help out. Imran is always a guy I could count on, and the Caribbean Voice always filling in, and a wonderful spokesperson for the Caribbean Voice as well as MC, our host and dose. Good night to the beautiful Sony Sukraj and Nasima Rohaman. How many of you are getting new friends or creating a new friend list as we encounter and we're entering 2019? Scratch those old friends off who are making you unhappy, who are pulling you down, and do something good for yourself. Get new friends.
Yes, please. Press reset button here. When 2019 comes, all those who don't serve purpose in your life, reset, bam.
They'll fall right off. And I see a lot of my friends are already doing that. They're cleaning up their Facebook page. Because you know what? There's so many people we have in our life that they don't add any value. They're just there.
Right.
You know, but they are observing. Peeping Toms, you could say. They're observing, but they add no positivity or no help to your life. So you know what? Let go. It's a good day to let go.
Yes. Another thing is that good sleeping habits. So hygiene. So, you know, if you get a good night's sleep, the day would be good for you. And I notice with my own self, if I don't get good sleep,
I'll be grumpy.
Oh, you take the word out of my mouth. You'll be grumpy all day. So the good thing, get your early sleep. Go to bed. Get a
and
nice
they
sleep.
Say beauty sleep, but beauty not just on the external, but it's an inside, makes you feel good.
Yes, get yourself prepared for the next day to face the world. And when you get good sleep, man, it nothing beats like a good sleep. And now I'm going to try to get some good sleep because I'm going to be home early. So Gita's lucky now.
Uh-oh, Gita. She says she's already in bed.
No, she's not. She always waits for daddy come home. Improve your eating habits. You know, it's always good to eat healthy. Nothing like eating healthy. When you eat healthy, you would get rid of things like diabetes and who knows more. Anna
your
knows
health
more.
Is your wealth. So remember, it's better to eat healthy now.
Yes.
And put in, as we were talking about fruits, we love fruits. The fruits from Guyana, that is. It's quite expensive, but you work for it. So why not enjoy it?
I spent $15 for just 2 Starapple last week.
And I had a whole bag thanks to my good friend Starapple, Sapodilla, and Sugar Apple. But you know what? Treat yourself to something that you enjoy. You guys work so hard. You know what? A Louis Vuitton bag doesn't make me happy as much as getting a bowl of fruits.
Right. I love my food, and especially when I go to Guyana, Shanaz.
Spend your money on health. You'll be taking pills later.
Yes, my sister-in-law and my brother-in-law, they know when I go to Ghana, from the time I touch down in Ghana, they have my fruits waiting for me. Thank you very much, guys. They're home. I'm sure they're watching, too.
Right.
Yeah, so thank you.
Give someone something healthy, and healthiness is, you know, health is your wealth, no matter how rich we are.
Yes.
If you don't have
eating
your health.
Healthy, if you eat healthy, then you would not bring on a lot of diagnosis.
Right.
On yourself, especially like diabetes and hypertension. Let's talk about learn how to stop negative thoughts. You know,
that's a very good topic.
Mm-hmm.
I zone them out.
Yeah. Keep positive thinking.
Okay.
Right? When you wake up, like I said, think you are the best bird there is. You're the best human being there is. That you love yourself. You know what I'm saying? That you will have a good day. that anybody come give you a hard time, that you are going to ride that over and you will enjoy the day. So keep your thoughts positive, and I'm sure that it's going to show in everything that you do. Okay?
Mr. Shabir Baksh, hey, welcome, the No Janjat founder. He said, make yourself number one, get in shape, physical activity, immerse yourself into activities so you enjoy and you just look good and feel good. I know Mr. Shabir is a very active person. Maybe that's why he's always so happy and he's always in his garden picking fruits.
Wow, we should get in touch with him.
Yes, we should get some sapodilla and some sugar apple out of Florida.
Oh, Lord Jesus. So now let's talk about, you know, we all like to procrastinate. I am a big procrastinator. So
tomorrow is a better day. Let's do it tomorrow.
Yeah, let's start.
And then tomorrow will come and be like, we'll do it another time. But that's such a waste of time, procrastinating.
Yes.
My motto is, let's make hay while the sun shines.
Exactly so. So it's a good thing to, you know, set yourself goals that's attainable, you know, small goals, short-term goals that you can do. Don't fight yourself to do too much one time. Mm-hmm. You know, cut them little by little.
As they say, Rome wasn't built in one day.
Yes. And especially if you are depressed, like if you have your whole house to clean, you know, you can start with the kitchen.
Right, but if you look at it as a whole,
oh my God,
it will make you depressed, right? Yeah, yeah. It might make you want to get out of the house, not just cleaning it.
Yeah, exactly.
So, you know, break down your chores into small portion. Mm-hmm. Tackle one task at a time. Do not overwhelm yourself.
Yes, and here it is. We get to see, get a handle of your household chores. That's what we were talking there too.
If you're visiting someone, right, and I open the door and I see a messy house, I already know something is going on.
Right.
That's my thing. Like, I like things to be in their place. Right? So if I see someone is piling up stuff, or maybe they're busy, but sometimes it has something to do with not just a lack of time, but how you're feeling.
Well, you know, Shanaz, I really do get to see what depression does, because most of the patients that I take care of, I'm surprised and appalled. A lot of times when I go to their apartment, I say sometimes to myself, how can human being live in this manner? Mm. You know, but my hands are tied sometimes. So, but it's sad to see how some people are depressed and they really don't have a lot of family
courage
to help and to help them to do things and so on. So, you know, all we can do is to encourage people to do well and to do what's good, you know.
Or if you see someone struggling with their basic household chores, offer a hand. You know, help your neighbor out, especially the elderly. Feel free to check on your neighbors, the elderly families and friends around the world. We always take life for granted. And, you know, tomorrow we'll talk on the phone. Next week we'll call them for her birthday. But tomorrow will never come. Make that time today.
Yes, yes. Create a wellness toolbox. Mm-hmm. A wellness toolbox is a set of tools that you can use. And we are not talking about
screwdriver. Okay,
we're not talking about that. You know, it suits yourself when you are feeling down. You know, the tool you find most helpful might not work for someone else. So it's important to carefully consider what things can help you feel your best.
Well, for me, I'm going to create my own toolkit. Music, food, and candles.
I know you like to dance too.
And dancing is a good meditation for me.
Yeah, yes. I see you on the show and you was ready to dance.
But I wasn't very depressed then.
I love to dance too.
I'm right?
What? I don't play. But I'm older now, so I calm down a little bit. You know what I'm saying?
Well, I believe the older we get, the more we should dance, because dancing is the best exercise.
Yeah, it's a good...
And you don't have to pay to go to the gym. Just exercise at home.
It's a good self-care therapy to dance. Mm-hmm.
Well, guys, because you're so good and so patient, we will start this oldies from the T.O.P. just for you guys. And Mr. Shabir Baksh, I know you enjoy it very well. Let's go. Compliments of the Caribbean voice.
तुझे देखा है कहीं पहले जाने मन ओ जाने जा जाने जहां मैंने तुझे देखा है कहीं पहले याद आता नहीं है कब कहां ओ जाने मन ओ जाने जा जाने जहां कैसे पल में बने जिंदगी ऐसे मिलके कोई अजनबी कैसे पल में बने जिंदगी जिसकी सूरत ख्यालों में थी ऐसा लगता है तुम हो वही मिल गई क्या खुशी छा गया क्या नशा
Enjoy. doing that too.
Yes.
Hey, good night, Auntie Jo and Bisun Liao. Where is everyone? Invite everyone to the chat box or share the link to your friends and see Lockdown 5S 101. We are talking about, hey, Priya Mohan, good night to you, good night to each and every one of you. Lockdown to 5S 101. Mr. Shabir Bach will be visiting Florida pretty soon. Hey, Mr. Sugram Pandit Sugram, good evening to you. And let's see. Puddling your pants is a terrible
thing.
Did you find that?
Yes,
it is. And cuddling your pants, listening to your favorite music, taking a warm bath, or even reading a good book is a form of meditation, a form of relaxation, and it's
helpful to relax again. Yes. Exactly. So dog is a man's best friend, so you can't go wrong if you have a dog. You know. Always encourage, you know, good things that make you happy. I'm going to say, so if you're depressed, go and do the things that you had liked to do before.
But you have no interest in that. If you're depressed, you always have
yeah, but you want to get up on the charge, you don't want to. So
baby
steps. Yeah, yes, exactly.
Baby.
You want to be baby steps. Start little. You know what I'm saying? You crawl and then you start to run. Okay? You know, Shanae, another thing is that when someone is depressed, sometimes they may be reluctant to really get help. So they may not accept you to go and try to help them. So it's always encouraged to go slowly with that person. You know, whoever it is, go slowly, encourage them, let them know that you're there to help them in the kindest way. If you're not there, you're going to talk about them, whatever it is, you know what I'm saying. Allow people to talk. Don't get yourself carried away if you want to diagnose them and you want to do everything to help them.
Listening is the best thing. All they need is an ear.
Yes, yeah. And you know, I learned that now too. But you know what? You know, I could talk, and so I now learned that, you know what, to stay quiet. And, you listen to what people have to say. Give them that opportunity and the time of the day to listen exactly, especially if they are like having depression or they need somebody to talk to. Like one of my friends, she lost her daughter. I last week I took her out to eat and I just wanted to hear what she had to say. I really wanted to support her because we went to high school together back in Ghana. I did not took her out for me to talk to her. I want to hear what she wants to tell me. And of course, you know, you try to encourage people to
I'm there
to listen and in a non-judgmental way. And if people know that you are not going to judge them, it's a free zone, I think people will open up and talk to you and want to discuss anything with you. You know,
Neela Pawaru Narayan says, how does someone find counseling? So where can we direct some people that's watching to get counseling?
Well, the thing is that you can even talk to your doctor, and your doctor can help you.
And that is your medical doctor.
Exactly. So are you talking to a psychiatrist? And they could help you. And they could send you to like a special counselor. It all depends whatever it is you're going to, a marriage counselor, a grief counselor, whatever the situation is. You know, there is help wherever you are. Actually, if you want, I'm located in Queens, New York. You can touch base with me after the show, and we can talk, and I can see how much I can help you. But definitely, there is help all over the place. We in the United States have a lot of places you can go. And for the people in Ghana, I don't know much, but you can go to the Caribbean Voice. You can touch base with the Caribbean Voice. And we definitely have people in Ghana who could help you and who can help you to navigate you to the care that you will need.
Right. Do add us on Facebook. That is the Caribbean Voice. Message us, inbox us, and Mr. Anandodram will direct you to where to get more medical help.
Good night to Sandra Singh.
Hey, Zahir Khan. Good night to you, Neela. Good night. I hope that helps. And Mr. Anand said, the Caribbean Voice is here for referral, also to counseling, so do reach out to us. Hey, George Muniram, good night to you. Mohan, how are you doing? Priya, good night. Hey, Claude Campbell, good night. Yes, it's the 80. We are going down the 80s. Joan Bisudiel, invite all your friends to watch us, and that is on 5S 101. Sajan, Sajan, mere Sajan. Thank you. Welcome back to the Caribbean Voice. And I see Mr. Hiram is still struggling with his cough and cold. He still need a lot more vitamin C or sunshine and orange juice and everything you need. And, you know, we talk about self-care. Our topic was self-care. You know, being dressed, well-dressed. Mm-hmm. On the outside, it looks like we're going to the salon. We're taking care of ourselves on the outside. But emphasize how important it is on self-care for inside, our mind and body.
Well, it's always good to feel good about yourself. And mm-hmm. It starts with you, inside of you. When you wake up in the morning, how do you see yourself? How do you see yourself? Are you ugly or whatever it is? You know what I'm saying? But always.
Well, normally when I wake up, my hair is not down. It's always up, like, you know, they said, a sensifier.
You're too right.
But nevertheless, a comb can make it better. So you put yourself together. We all need to do the basic steps. Get up, brush teeth, put yourself together. Look in the mirror. Do not judge yourself by the outer appearance. Judge yourself from the heart and what you have to offer the world.
And Shanaz, I think that people are beautiful in so many ways. Mm-hmm. And I'm not talking about facial beauty, because, and don't get carried away with that, because one thing I learned with life and seeing a lot of patients mm-hmm. is that those things, you lose them.
Material things.
You look beautiful tomorrow. You know, you don't know what life holds for you mm-hmm. tomorrow. So let not beauty alone get you carried away. We don't know what life is holds for you tomorrow.
One day you could be walking very well. The next day, you have a broken leg. You're limping. You walk with a cane. And so many good people I see suffering when it comes to medical. Because you know what? They wait until the last minute to take care of themselves. You have kids. You have a husband. You have a job. We always put everything else first. But sometimes you need to let everything sit for a little bit and put yourself first. Taking care of yourself.
Yes. I'm smiling because I see Joan says, drink lemon water. Joan, to be honest, I have been trying everything to get rid of this cold. And it's so tough. But I'll have to be more aggressive with the treatment as of tomorrow, because I don't like to be in the studio when I'm coughing. And I you know what I'm saying? But thank you very much, guys. And, if you're depressed.
Or if you know someone is depressed.
Yes. Important.
If you know someone struggling with depression,
reach out to that person and see how best you can help them. Especially now the holidays coming up, help somebody. Even if you have to take, you have a neighbor that you don't even want them to come by you, you can dish up some nice food, some good food that you cook, and you can send it over for them. I am very lucky that I have good neighbors. The Roberts, they always send over stuff for my sons. And
do they like dal and rice and fish curry, like you said earlier? You made dal and rice. I know what he had for dinner already. It was dal and rice.
Yeah, dal and rice and saw fish.
So I'm sure you will make someone happy by sharing.
Yes. So, you know, we at the show here, we want to help you guys. We want to empower you that when you go to your doctor, that you would know exactly what to say and what not to say and what to expect from your doctor or your psychiatrist. And we want to wish you all the very best that life has to offer. We want to empower you every day to do good, to choose the good things in life, to eat good, to exercise, to have a full life. Because I always tell people that this life is a one-shot deal. You're not coming back tomorrow as your own self. If you believe in reincarnation, you probably come in somebody else. But if you believe in Christianity, you're not coming back, okay? And I'm not really preaching religion. I just want people to know this is a one-shot deal. You don't have to stay in any abusive situation. You don't have to stuck being depressed. It's not a life sentence. Mm-hmm. You can get treatment.
And do you know that most people, they live upon what others think of themselves, you know? You live to please others. At the end of the day, others are not paying your bills, so live for you.
Yes. Exactly so. You have to live for yourself. Don't break the bank to nobody else.
Don't try to impress anybody by buying luxury things like a car and bags. I have coworkers who would like to be on the schedule 7 days a week because they love Louis Vuitton, they love this. But remember, you're taking time away from your family. You're taking time away from your kids who need you. Why? All because you need a beautiful bag to look good. It all starts up here. You have to feel good about yourself, because carrying a pocketbook does not make you look better. Wearing 500 bracelets does not make you, you know, maybe they have low self-esteem.
Hey, that could be too. people low self low self esteem, mm-hmm. they do all manner of things. They put people down too.
Right. They take that's another source of bullying and misery. And I did comment on that when we were saying that let go of all the negative friends and colleagues that you have. And he commented that they might need help themselves, because if I'm hanging out with you all day and all you could talk is negativity, that's all you have to offer, of course I might recommend you getting some help, because you know that's not healthy, and I don't want to be associated with negative folks unless I'm there to help.
Yes, and I always like to in my daily life, Shanaz, I've met so much beautiful people. I came to this country 28 years ago, and all the people I've met, most of them, 98% of the people I met were nice people that always helped me to fly. And the latest one I met, and don't get carried away, I mean, you know what I mean? But it's you. You know, I met you a couple weeks now, and because of the Caribbean Voice.
Months, and I must thank you for coming out and supporting as a member of the Caribbean Voice. He came out to support the Concert for Hope we had. And the Concert for Hope was started by our member, Mr. Satish Udayaram, and we are organizing a couple more concerts, seeing that you brought it up. We are organizing a concert in California. We are going to Guyana. And right here, every July or August, we have one organized by Mr. Hiram and myself on behalf of the Caribbean Voice. So it's a non-for-profit organization. Do follow us. Tell your friends and your family to support us. And we are hoping to launch a memorabilia site where you can get T-shirts and everything to support Caribbean Voice.
Good thing. Good. It's a good thing.
So a lot of things happening. So keep us, follow us on Facebook and WhatsApp, message the Caribbean Voice, and we are here to help. Suicide prevention is everybody's business, and do not let negativity keep you down.
Yes, yes. Always, it's best to give somebody compliment. If somebody look nice, just say, hey, you look nice today, mm-hmm. rather than you say, look at she.
You could wear a different shirt, you know, it would have gone, no, just...
Yeah, it's best to compliment people for good stuff rather than go back-talk people, you know, for bad stuff that you don't know about anyway. So, and we are not perfect, you know what I'm saying? And I am getting there. I'm not perfect, but I want to do good. Mm-hmm. And I want to help somebody. And every day of my life, I want to do something to help somebody.
But that makes you feel good about yourself.
Of course,
you're a person who likes to help. And giving is something that makes me feel good too, helping them whatever way we can. It doesn't have to be financially. I know everybody,
exactly,
when you think of helping, everyone says, well, I don't have the finances. It doesn't have to be finances financially. It could be a gesture. It could be taking someone to the gym, like someone offered to, you know, take me to the gym. So
yeah.
I'll be going to the gym pretty soon.
Oh, that's nice. It's a good thing. It's keep you healthy.
Yeah. It releases happy hormones, right?
Yes, yes. And keep you fit and slim like you are, and trim, you know what I mean? So it's a good, and it makes you feel good, Shanaz.
Mm-hmm.
I might start go gym too, because I'll have the time.
Well, and we could have our own gym workout in the Fire Fest studio right here. Auntie Una said, if you don't have something good to say, stay quiet. That's very good advice, Auntie Una. And they said, look could be deceiving. Auntie Joan said that. And Auntie Joan also said, Kenneth, you look very handsome. So thank you very much. You see, we have nice friends. They're
well,
saying good
very
things.
Much. Thank you, Joan. You've been very generous with your comment.
Steve, good night to you. Thank you guys very much. Whatever we have a little bit we should offer, because you never know, whatever little we have, someone have none.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. So it's always good. You know, Shanaz, growing up, of all the things that I went through in life, I take those things and make a stepping stone for me. And I don't say these things in a braggadocious way at all. I been a nurse for over 28 years, and I could not have chosen a better career. And I always tell young people, as we have the forum here, I hope that we have some young people listening. I always tell the young girls them that, you know what, and the young boys, make sure you go to school, get an education, make yourself marketable.
That is a
nobody
gift someone
can
take
you a
from
hard
you,
time.
Right. That's something
you
no one can take from you, an education.
Yeah, and if your husband giving you a hard time or your wife giving you a hard time, you can move on and do great things for your own self. Don't depend on anybody else.
Independence
is
right?
The great
education,
thing.
Education, you can be independent. You also need a little motivation and the right folks, because I know some really good friends who, you know, didn't go all the way to college.
Right.
But they have good support system that motivate them, and they have good jobs and, you know,
reaching back
out there. And everyone falls now and then, is how you get up.
True story.
That's how you get up. And do not ever let that fall keep you down.
Get up, brush up, and run for roses. I did it, and probably one day I will tell you my story, how I get up and I brush up and run, especially when people keep putting you down and telling you. Oh, a good thing I want to say is that, you know, I was told many times, you know, I'm nothing, I'm no good, I'll be nobody in life, you know what I'm saying? And I took those things to heart. I used to cry sometimes, but I don't cry no more.
I'm sure you and use it in a way to motivate you.
I use it in a way to motivate me. When I was told that, you know what, it's better I plant a coconut tree than I make you, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. It was bad and sad those times. But now I am so grateful and so glad that I was able to put those things aside and make, as you said, make a stepping stone and keep flying. I fly high. I'm like the eagle.
Those comments inspire you. If you look at it that way, they inspire you to be better and show them and prove them wrong. Yes. And you know, you never know the talent and the potential you have. And sometimes you need that negativity to make a positive.
Yes, don't let yourself down. I mean, if you go down, you get up and you brush up and you run. And don't, again, I'm going to say, don't let nobody define you and tell you who you are. Let you know, I mean, we're going to close up soon. You are the best thing, like I said, that God made.
You could be a candle in someone's darkness.
Yeah, got it. I love that. You're a card. Yeah, you never know how your light could be bright.
Right. And as I said, sometimes, why some folks only call upon me on certain times, you know? He didn't think about me yesterday. He didn't think of me yesterday. Last week he had a wedding, but he's thinking of me today. Well, this is your chance to shine. This is when he needs you the most.
Yeah.
So this is your opportunity to do good. Every day is a day to do good for someone. Take care of yourself, not just on the outside, but on the inside. Eat well, sleep well, and remember to have good friends and talk to your doctor regularly.
Yes, and whatever you choose to do in life, always choose kindness. Always choose to be kind.
And smile. It goes far. You never know who might need a smile to brighten their day.
बेखुदी की राहें ये हसीन लब नशीले ये झुकी झुकी निगाहें तेरे हुस्न ने दिखाई मुझे बेखुदी की राहें ये हसीन लब नशीले ये झुकी झुकी निगाहें तेरी जुल्फ से उठी है ये घटाओं की जवानी तेरे पास मेरा दिल है मेरे प्यार की निशानी मुझे इश्क है तुझसे मेरी जान जिंदगानी तेरे पास मेरा दिल है मेरे प्यार की निशानी मुझे इश्क है तुझसे
Well, folks, good evening. Happy Monday. We're going into Tuesday. The Monday went by so fast.
Yes.
I guess they said when you're having fun, time flies. And it went through out the window. Thank you guys for keeping us company here every Monday, 8 to 10 p.m. And hey, Mr. Hiram will be here, our weekly co-host of the Caribbean Voice Mind and Body Connection.
Well, thank you very much for welcoming me, Shanaz. And I know we're wrapping up. And I want to say thank you to you guys for tuning in tonight. Please don't forget to share our page on Firefest 101 Radio here in New York and Facebook Live. Always, again, until next week, Monday, please continue to be kind and be a blessing to somebody. Okay?
They might need it. Hey, Darko, good evening to you. Nina Boyce, good evening. Auntie Joan, thank you very much. Scott Kane, good evening to you. Mr. Annan said, when you know better, you do better. Linda Singh, good evening and welcome back. Old is definitely gold, Auntie Joan. Debbie, good evening to you. Sharing is caring. Help. Hit share so someone could benefit or join the Caribbean Voice chat next week. Mr. Kabir Das, good evening to you. Remember, next I believe on December 23rd at the Royal Indian Palace. There is a grand show. I'll post it up on my Facebook wall. Liberty Palace, I believe. On behalf of the Mandir, thank you, Mr. Kabir Das. Until next time, thank you to the management and staff of Firefest 101. Thank you for keeping us company.
Thank you.
Sharing is caring. Until next Monday, have yourself a blessed and productive week ahead.
Yes. Bye-bye.